Chapter 2 Self-Discipline and Commitment. It was character that got us out of bed, commitment that moved us into action, and discipline that enabled us to follow through. If you cannot do great things, do small things in a great way, by Napoleon Hill. This is one of the first chapters because it will be the foundation of your future success. Your way to success and happiness is deeply connected to your willpower and commitment. These character traits will decide whether you do what you said you would do and go through with it. This will keep you going towards your goals even when everything seems to go against you. Self-discipline is going the things you need to do even if you are not in mood for it. If you train to be self-disciplined and have the will to succeed, you can do great things in your life. But even if you don't have the slightest bit of self-discipline within you right now, don't worry. You can start training your self-discipline and willpower from this moment on. Self-discipline is like a muscle. The more you train it, the better you get it. If your self-discipline is weak right now, start training by setting yourself small, reachable goals. Write down the success you have and keep in mind that you don't have limits, only the ones you set for yourself. Visualize the benefits you will have at the end of the road. For example, if you want to go running at 6 a.m. in the morning and you just don't seem to make it out of bed, imagine how good you will feel when you are at the fitness level that you want to be and how great you will look. Then jump out of the bed, put on your running clothes and go. This book will only work if you have the will and discipline to make it work. What is your word worth? Take your commitments seriously, because not keeping your commitments has terrible consequences. You lose energy. You lose keeping your commitments has terrible consequences. You lose energy. You lose clarity. You get confused along the way to your goals. And even worse, you lose self-confidence. And your self-esteem takes a hit. To avoid this, you have to become aware of what is really important to you and act in line with your values. A commitment is a choice. Only make commitments that you really want. That can mean fewer commitments and more no's. If you commit, keep your commitment, whatever it takes. Give them the importance and value that they deserve and be aware of the consequence of not keeping them. Chapter 3. Take full responsibility for your life. Peak performance begins with your taking complete responsibility for your life and everything that happens to you, by Brian Tracy. Most people do not really want freedom because freedom involves responsibility and most people are frightened of responsibility. This is only one person that's responsible for your life. And that is you. Not your boss, not your spouse, not your parents, not your friends and not your clients. Not the economy, not the weather. You. The day we stop blaming others for everything that happens in our life, everything changes. Take responsibility for your life is taking charge of your life and becoming the protagonist of it. Instead of being a victim of circumstances, you obtain the power to create your own circumstances, or at least the power to decide how you are going to act in the face of circumstances that life presents to you. It doesn't matter what happens to you in your life. It matters what attitude you adopt, and the attitude you adopt is your choice. If you blame your life situation on others, what has to happen to make your life better? All the others have to change, and that, my friend, I tell you, is not going to happen. If you are the protagonist, you have the power to change the things that you don't like in your life. You are in control of your thoughts, actions and feelings. You are in control of your words, the series you watch on television and the people you spend your time with. If you don't like your results, change your input, your thoughts, emotions and expectations. Stop reacting to others and start responding. Reaction is automatic. Responding is consciously choosing your response. You take your life in your own hands, and what happens? A terrible thing. No one to blame. Erica Jong. The victim says, every bad thing in my life is others' fault. But if you're not a part of the problem, then you also can't be a part of the solution. Or, in other words, if the problem is caused by the outside, the solution is also on the outside. If you're coming in late to work because of traffic, what has to happen so that you can get to work on time? Traffic has to disappear magically, because as long as there is traffic, you will always be late. Or you can act like protagonist and leave home on time. Then it depends on you. So once again, even if you don't have control over the stimuli the environment sends you continuously, you have the liberty to choose your behavior in facing the situation. The person with the victim mentality only reacts, is always innocent and constantly blaming others for his or her situation, while using the past as justification and putting the hopes on our future, which will miraculously bring solution to problems or a change in others who are causing the troubles. The protagonist knows that he or she is responsible, chooses adequate behavior and holds himself accountable. He uses the past as a valuable experience from which to learn, live in the present where he sees constant opportunities for change and decides and goes after his future goals. The most important question is, who will you choose to be by your actions when life presents you with these circumstances? Gandhi said it very nicely. They can take away our self-respect if we don't give to them. Ask yourself the following question. Who are you blaming for your life situation right now? Your partner, your boss, your parents, your friends. What would happen if you stop blaming the others for what happens to you in your life? What would happen if you would stop being a victim of the circumstances? Is it comfortable for you being a victim? What benefits does it have for you to be a victim? What would happen if you stopped suffering in your life and took the decision to change it? What would you change? Where could you start? How would you start? And the action step is, write down 5 things that you can do in coming week to start changing the course and start taking charge of your life. Chapter 4. Choices and Decisions. Once you make a decision, the universe conspires to make it happen. Ralph Waldo Emerson. Maybe you have heard that your life is the result of the decision you made. How do you feel about that? Is it true for you? It's important that from now on, you are aware of the power you have over your life by making decisions. Every decision, every choice has an important influence on your life. In fact, your life is a direct result of the choices and decisions you made in the past, and every choice carries a consequence. Start making better choices. Remember that you choose your thoughts and even your feelings. The most important thing is to make decision. Whether the decision is right or wrong is secondary. You will soon receive feedback that will help you to progress. Once you have made a decision, go with it and take the consequences. If it was wrong, learn from it and forgive yourself, knowing that at that point in time and with the knowledge you had, it was the best and the right decision to take. Your attitude plus your decision is your life. Viktor Frankl was a Jewish psychologist imprisoned in Germany's concentration camps during the Second World War. He lost his entire family except his sister. Under these terrible circumstances, he became aware of what he named the ultimate human freedom, which not even the Nazi prison wards could take away from him. They could control his external circumstances, but in the last instance, it was him who chose how these circumstances were going to affect him. He found out that between the stimulus and response, there was a small space in time in which he had the freedom to choose his response. This means that even if you move, you may not be able to control the circumstances that life presents to you. You can always choose your response in facing those circumstances, and by doing so, have a huge impact on your life. In other words, what hurts us is not what happens to us, but our response to what happens to us. The most important thing is how we respond to what happened to us in our life, and that's a choice. Do you want to be healthier? Make better choices about food and exercise. Do you want to be more successful? Make better decisions about your surrounds yourself with what you read and what you watch. There are no excuses. Forgive me if I make the assumption that your life situation is not worse than the Viktor Frankl when he made this discovery. For me, being a Jew in German concentration camp in WW2 is bad as it gets. Question to ask yourself, why decisions could you make today to start to change? Will you choose to be more flexible, more positive, healthier, happier? And the action steps, write down at least 3 changes that you want to do, make today. Read Viktor Frankl's book, Man in Searching of Meaning.